Sport. In this edition, we meet the Jamaican shot putter O'Dane Richards preparing for the Summer Games. And we look at the island's university sports program that has produced stars like Usain Bolt. In part two, we talk to the Secretary General of the International University Sports Federation, Eric Santron, on the subject of new sports and the introduction of different disciplines. And later, we'll travel to Germany to meet the former world champion and Olympic medalist, Betty Heidler, who won the women's hammer at the Universiade in 2009. I'm Richard Vaughan. Welcome to Campus. Jamaica is universally known for its top track athletes. But the 2011 World University Games brought a new name and another discipline into the spotlight. The name is O'Dane Richards. He's 24 years old, and his passion is to throw things.
Actually, a moment when you throw and the implement starts to get small as it goes away from you, and that moment you know that you have done really well, all the training has come together. So that's what I like about the sport.
Through high school and college, O'Dane was a devotee of the discus and the shot put. But like most of the Jamaican students, his first goal was to get a good education.
From St. George's College, I wanted to do the animation, but it didn't offer it, so it was a computing school. So I thought that I could use this as a stepping stone to go to the next level. When I started UTEC in 2007, I had not thrown the senior weight. So I started about probably 15 meters. And then I didn't have a steady coach. So this was where I first met Mr. Swaby. And he was trained to do the throws because he was also a thrower himself. He was also coached by Stephen Francis. So I started to get the coaching aspect of it, the more technical details of the sport, and I realized it as I did that, my distances started to improve.
Linville Swaby is the throwing coach of the MVP Track and Field Club, an assistant at the University of Technology in Kingston. He saw the talent of O'Dane.
His technique was okay compared to the other guys because he actually did the rotation from in high school, and most of the other guys in high school did the glide. So, you know, I was fascinated by it. He seemed compact, that was one. You know, I saw him and I realized that, you know, with a few minor adjustments, you know, him could be a better thrower. So I started pursuing, you know, him to come in here, you know.
But like most student athletes, the challenge for O'Dane Richards was to perform at the top level in both sport and academic study.
At UTEC, education is first. We try to, you know, implore upon the athletes, the students, to actually try to graduate because, you know, after the sport, you know, you need a life. So I saw him first as a student, but an athlete is right as close to it because I would like him to be a professional athlete, but I would like him to also have his qualifications.
Sport gave O'Dane a certain discipline, but the education system definitely helped to structure him to become a complete athlete.
It was extremely demanding. It pressured you to keep focus on what you were about, you know. You had to get the grades, and you wanted to do well at the athletics, so it was really demanding. Sleepless nights. There was one time where I had to stay on campus and study right through the night just to get the grades.
After his arrival at UTEC in 2009, the young thrower improved all his marks and became the Universiade champion in 2011, a competition that gave him the motivation to go on to break his own personal records.
If it wasn't for the World University Games, I didn't think I'd have thrown 19.9 that year. I don't think that I would have pushed myself. I'd probably go to a meet in the area in the Caribbean, but the competition level is not that high. And because of what FISU has done, it gave me an opportunity to rub shoulder to shoulder with some of the big names in the sport. Like Mark Israel, he threw in the discus. Mason Finley threw in the shot. He's a big number one in the US. So without FISU, I don't think it would have given me the impact that I have today.
The University Games gave him the boost he needed to keep improving, out to 2 meters 31 in the shot put.
It gave me a look into the future, where I believe that some of those guys that competed at the World University Games would be future Olympians. So if I could get the best of them at World University Games, maybe it would translate into getting a gold medal at the Olympics, World Championships, or any other meet that matters.
So this July in Kazan, the Jamaican will be there to defend his title at the World University Games on the road to that potential Olympic medal. Jamaica has a population of less than 3 million, but there are 45,000 students in the island's university and college system. It's a system generally based on British education. Intercol is the governing body with the job of developing and promoting the strength of university sport.
We recognize that we have some very talented student athletes here in Jamaica, and we can put together a championships that can hone these skills, that can develop these skills, that can build them to the national level. And we think, especially in track and field, a lot of our athletes do better who stay home. So we believe that there's a system here that can help to develop those talents.
Following the detection work made in high school, the prestigious University of Technology of Jamaica offers educational programs leading to a career in sport.
We've been particularly careful to ensure these students get mentoring, okay? And we follow them to ensure that they are following up on their academic programs, and where they have difficulties, we see how best we can assist them. What we have done at UTEC in particular is to facilitate by a flexibility of programming. The usual 3 year could easily be extended to 4 or 5 years, and allowing them to accumulate or bank their credits towards acquiring their degree, and allowing them the chance to maximize their sporting potential. But when some of our student athletes are, for example, on retreat or training, for example, in Australia, they will submit their assignments via email and the technology support.
Among the 12,000 students at UTEC, 400 follow one of the sports programs.
Sport, as it's, and of itself, is a tremendous trainer for self-discipline, time management, and you learn what it means to go that extra mile. We have in our midst a number of students who have excelled in terms of the academics.
The island's two big institutions, UTEC and the University of the West Indies, have provided some of the best athletes of all time, and the University Games have brought that talent to light.
World University Games 2 years ago did something magnificent for us as a country. We sent, I think it was 12 athletes and got 9 medals, and those medals helped to push and propel our track and field program in Jamaica a bit more. Say for Odane Richards was one of those guys, and he got the gold in the shot put. Hansa Parchment later went to the Olympics and copped a bronze medal in the 110 hurdles. He won the 110 hurdles at the World University Games. We'd want to send a lot more athletes, but we're in a situation of financial challenges within the entire world, and certainly here also, so we won't be able to send them, you know, the great amount that we want. But over a period of time, probably the next 2 years and 4 years' time, we'll be able to send a very large contingent who will be doing well.
With a proven system in place and a new generation of athletes, we'll no doubt see more Jamaican success at the forthcoming Universiade. In part two of Campus, how FISU has pioneered sports like women's ski jumping, basketball 3-on-3, and rugby sevens. Stay with us.
In life and sport, dealing with the challenges ahead requires focus, concentration, and a will to succeed. The International University Sports Federation promotes sports values in tune with the academic spirit. Thousands of student athletes from around the world participate in FISU's world-class sport competitions. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
News of our campus team on the road to Kazan. This, the Australian swimmer, David McKean. One of a handful of athletes we're following in their preparations for this summer's University Games. A few days ago, he was in fine form at the Australian National Championships, brilliantly winning the 400 metres freestyle, stopping the clock in 3 minutes 43.71. The time took him to third spot on the Australian all-time list behind Hackett and Thorpe. It also launched him to number two in this year's world rankings, just behind the Chinese Olympic champion Sun Yang. And it secured his place in the World Championships that'll take place later this summer. Incidentally, he also took silver in the 200 meters freestyle. Yulia Zarapova is another member of our campus team. She's the 3,000 meter steeplechase Olympic champion. Right now, she's still in Russia training for her season with two important goals, the Kazan Universiade in July and the World Championships in Moscow in August. Over the past few weeks, she's moved her training base from the south of Russia to Cheboksary in the Kazan region. Our Polish badminton player, Wojciech Skudlarczyk, has taken his second title of the season with his doubles teammate, Lukasz Moren. In the Dutch Open final, they beat the English pair, Coles and Birmingham, in three sets. International Sports Federation was created in 1949, since when it's played an important part in the development of the world of sports. There are 27 different sports at this year's Summer Universiade and 13 different disciplines at the Winter Universiade. And from women's ski jumping to rugby sevens, FISU has been a pioneer. FISU has always been there at the origin of new disciplines, new events. Sports federations found that FISU was a really interesting way to carry out trials in university sport. Looking back, it was the case, for instance, for judo, with the new weight categories. We were the first to back snowboarding, even before it was integrated into the International Ski Federation. We were also the first to launch ski jumping for women. And in our development, we always try to integrate women's sport to the maximum. And today, I think there are more women's than men's disciplines in the FISU sports program. The Rugby Sevens tournament in Kazan is going to be fantastic with a worldwide competition. And we're very proud and happy that this sport is going to be present at Rio 2016. Obviously, it's a great joy for us if we've contributed a little bit to enable some sports to enter the Olympic family. Sports like chess, the team saber in fencing, and women's ice hockey are among the sports of the University Games.
L'avantage que nous avons, c'est que nous sommes pas limités dans notre
Our advantage is that we don't have any limit in our programs. We have around 50 disciplines, and we still have space. In our program, we have the category of what we can call Olympic sports, with all the main sports that we have at the Olympic Games. But besides that, we're open to new disciplines. The IOC has a lot of difficulties in changing its program, and we can see that with all the talk about it nowadays. It's difficult for them to remove sports and add sports, but it's much easier for us. Last year, FISU collaborated with the International Basketball Federation to organize the first World University Basketball 3-on-3 Championship in Serbia, a perfect example of innovation. When we're introducing a new sport, we have to be sure that the new sport will be a success. For sure, basketball 3-on-3 is the symbol of a university sport. You take the ball, you're with your friends, you're on a small court on the campus, and you spend 1 hour of happiness. It's important to listen to what the students want to do, and obviously, traditional sports are not always what youngsters and students like to be involved with. That's why we're always considering new disciplines, and we're always ready to give the opportunity to students to have real events and competitions with rules that are adapted to what they like.
D'une compétition sportive avec de nouveaux sports, mais également adapter des règles à ce qu'ils aiment.
FISU has a membership of 163 national university federations. Such a breadth of countries from five continents has influenced the diversity of FISU sports. Our member associations are reflecting what's happening in each country around the world where we have university sports. We make inquiries, and every 2 years, we redefine our future program, submitting new disciplines to our executive committee. It's a system by which FISU has demonstrated a concrete role as innovator in the world of sport. I think that all the international sports federations, because they care about making or keeping their sports popular, they have to bring some originality in the way they're organizing their competitions. There are some sports that are more traditional and are developing less because, especially, of the rules. But there are other sports like basketball 3-on-3 where we're trying to bring some freshness to it all. Of campus, we'll meet Betty Heidler, the German hammer thrower who won the gold at the 2009 Universiade, 2 years after becoming world champion. She tells us her story. With the approach of the University Games, Krasnoyarsk has become the fourth Russian city to welcome the Universiade torch relay. A special day for the Siberian city. It's one of the bidders to host the 2019 Winter Universiade. Roller skaters and cyclists took part in the relay, introducing an alternative way of carrying the torch before it moved on to Volgograd. The Olympic pool in Kazan has seen various Russian test competitions in the past few weeks, the diving championship, the swimming cup final, and the synchronized championship, with more than 200 synchro swimmers from 15 Russian regions taking part. During the event, officials announced that Russia will send its A-team to compete at the University Games. It'll help the Russian synchro swimmers gear up for the World Championships in Kazan in 2015. This month on campus, our FISU heroine is an expert with the hammer, Betty Heidler of Germany, the bronze medalist from London 2012. She first got involved with athletics at the age of 14, and when she discovered the throwing disciplines, especially the hammer, nothing could stop her. I developed my abilities so quickly in this sport, and then one day the hammer throw coach asked me after a competition if I wanted to go and try it. That's what I did, and I'm still doing it.
bin hängen geblieben.
In 2001, following her passion and keen to improve, she moved from Berlin to Frankfurt. And since then, Betty Heidler has consistently shown incredible willpower to go on improving in a discipline reputed to be tough. I love hammer throwing because it's so complex. Hammer throwing is not easy at all. It's a really demanding sport. The moving, the movements are very difficult. And if you make only the smallest mistake, it has an immediate effect. It's a big challenge to produce a perfect throw, but that's something that motivates you, and you're always working on improving it.
Und das ist das, was mich anspornt.
The German star studies law at Goethe University in Frankfurt and tries to combine her sports career with life as a student. But Heidler is lucky. She's helped by an understanding university. The university is very supportive in the sense that I'm not obliged to do full-time studying. So I have a lot of time off compared to the other students. Of course, I'll need more time than the others to finish the course. But if I miss important exams due to training camps or competitions, they allow me to do them afterwards. So I'm able to study and to be an athlete. Betty Heidler really showed her talent at the 2007 World Championships in Osaka. She threw 74.76 meters to take the gold medal, just 2 centimeters better than Yipsy Moreno from Cuba. So 2 years later, she arrived at the University Games in Belgrade as the reigning world champion. Her opponents were impressed.
There were throwers there who weren't among the world's best, who hadn't taken part in the European Championships or the World Championships or the Olympic Games. But I knew what they were about because they were like me, athletes who were studying and taking part in the University Games. It was a very mixed field. I was very relaxed. But the competition was also of a very high standard.
The 25th Summer Universiade was held with 145 nations and 10,000 athletes taking part. Betty Heidler was in form. With 75.83 meters, she took the gold.
When
I started the competition, I was really nervous because I knew that the field was really good and that my opponents could throw a long way. So I didn't expect to have an excellent start in the competition, but I produced many long and stable throws, and even one of 74.75 meters. And yes, I won it and came back home with that victory. The success story of Betty continued at the European Championships 1 year later in Barcelona. Victory again, this time with a throw of 76.38 meters. Now she had the European title to add to that university crown that still has a special meaning for her. I think the Universiade competition is very important. First of all, for the students. It's a real motivation for them to take part. Then the atmosphere is similar to that at the European Championships or the Worlds or the Olympic Games. It's a really outstanding event. And I'm really proud that my Universiade record is still valuable, although the athletes since then have been so good. But my Universiade win is one of those moments that are at the top of my success list, and that makes me really, really proud. Halle, May the 21st, 2011, the day Betty Heidler entered athletics history. She threw the hammer 79 meters 42, a world record. Here's her advice to the athletes of the upcoming University Games in Kazan. I know it demands effort, and it's difficult being in a village where there are so many athletes to stay focused. You can easily lose concentration and forget what's the priority. It's important to enjoy the atmosphere, to be with the other athletes. Then, though, you have to be refocused on your competition. But after your competition, you have to be a supporter of your team and be at their competition. Have fun, because that's also important. World, European, and Universiade champion, and the current world record holder. Betty Heidler has proved that by combining talent with hard work, anything is achievable. And at the age of 29, the FISU heroine is still highly motivated for the 2016 Olympics in Rio.
That's it from this edition of Campus. Next month, we'll put the spotlight on Kazan, Russia's self-proclaimed capital of sport, as it prepares to host the Summer University Games.